This is the first treatment in 8.5 years that I've had that's been new for ovarian specifically, and couldn't have come at a better time. Hi, my name is Jackie Van Raphorst. I'm 58 years old, and I am a retired IT professional as a project manager, and I'm 8.5 years into a stage 3 ovarian cancer diagnosis. I have a very extensive family history of cancer. I started having pains in my stomach, pretty substantial pains, one to the point where I was at a grocery store and I abandoned ship and left my card and called my doctor immediately. So she did an exam and didn't find anything. And so she said, well, why don't we get you to a GI doctor and maybe that's the answer for you. I had an ultrasound on a Friday, a CT scan on a Monday, and was called back to the doctor that day. And that's never a good sign when you have to go in to get your results. My sister went with me and my doctor said, you have cancer. I don't really remember much after that. I think I cried quite a bit, but yeah, it was a devastating diagnosis. Really, time sort of stops and you just go from one thing to the next. You don't think any farther in advance than just one thing. And the one thing was going to be a massive surgery as quickly as possible and do a total hysterectomy. Then the word chemo comes up and it's like, you know you need it, but you don't want to go through it. And I saw that, you know, I have all of these friends that are signing up to drive me to and from treatment, bring us food, you know, take care of whatever needed to be taken care of. And I thought, well, if they're going to work that hard, then I'm going to work that hard. Just accepted what was and shaved my head and away we went. And it's been 8.5 years of really great support and, you know, a lot of chemo, but really great support. We thought we had beaten it. And then at one of my CT scans and my CA125 tests came back and it was elevated to the point where we try the next drug. And it never stopped from there. I think I would get maybe 3 to 6 months at a point where I wouldn't be in treatment. We got to the point where we had been through PARP inhibitors and immunotherapies and targeted therapies and multiples of those. So we started to recycle drugs because we had sort of run out of options. And that's when this new drug called Elahere came to be. And I had to sort of jump through all of the hoops to be able to even receive it. I've been through them all, so hopefully this is the one. I have two specific friends that are my very good best friends for 30 years now, and they've been through it all with me. But my sister's really been my main support. She goes to all of my treatments with me. My support system has been key in all of this and pushing me forward, because there are just days where you can't get up. You just can't get up. I do have pretty substantial peripheral neuropathy in my hands and my feet, which make it hard for me because I am a lifelong crafter, and to pick up, you know, my pliers and my tools and stuff is very difficult for me. And the fatigue is really what's getting me. I take a long time after my treatment to sort of bounce back. It could be so much worse. We started with a baseline scan in April, and I have a scan on next Thursday, I think, or next Friday, to see where we've come internally. I've been through 4 cycles so far. My CA125 has dropped 500 points, which is amazing. So in my opinion, the CT is gonna be positive and show me that it's either no progression or even better would be to have it shrink. I will now become a bigger advocate for research and funding and all of that. All cancer patients want one thing, and that is time. And that's what these new drugs and all the research that goes behind these new drugs is affording us. And that, I think, impacts everybody with cancer. I wouldn't be 8.5 years into what's typically a 5-year, at best, diagnosis if I didn't have these drugs. And so it's extremely important to continue the research and development on new drugs for all different types of cancer.